Have you ever wondered how to save out a drawing template or modify that title block area and put it in a place that other coworkers could use it? Well, today we're going to show you how to save out a drawing template on a network location so everyone could use the same drawing templates. If I just go into the software, we're going to end up with something like this. We'll add our company logo to the title block and do a little bit of modification. I like to start from some kind of pre-existing template. We have the training templates for download for free. If I start with one of those training templates, let's say I have an A-sized landscape and a B-sized landscape drawing, but I want to really have an A-sized portrait, and I want to have some title block modifications that we don't have to do every time. So the first thing I'll do here is change it to the A portrait size. To do that, we can right-click anywhere we see the sheet name, and we can go to properties. That's the sheet properties. And it'll pop up a box like this. Now, if we want to change the sheet size, we just have to pick a new sheet format. Let's use the A ANSI portrait at first and hit apply changes. Now, I have a portrait size page. That's something that could get saved into this template. And another thing, now we'll make some title block changes. We'll put a logo in and change some things up in here. If I right click on the sheet out in the graphics area and choose edit sheet format, I can drop into the title block area. This is just a sketch, so anything in the sketch tab will work down here. We can trim entities. I could cut this whole area out if we don't really use this. Bam. Power trim it all out. Let's see. Something like that. And maybe we delete these couple notes. And maybe I move this stuff over. I'm going to grab this note and hit the S key. Maybe move entities with the search bar that the S key brings up and grab that and move it over. Something like that. Maybe we'll even end up putting a company logo in here instead of this note about proprietary and confidential. I'll just close this off with the line tool. And to put a image in there, we can go find our logo somewhere. We can use the Microsoft snipping tool. And we could take a new snip of that logo. Something like this. And now if I click on the top toolbar of here, I can do a Control C to copy that image. I can click into SOLIDWORKS and do a Control V. And now we've just copy pasted that logo. When we save this out, everything in the background turns to white. It's not going to stay looking like it does. Now I'll just resize this box a little bit so it fits this logo a little better. Yeah, something like this. Resize the logo a little bit. You can see that was pretty straightforward to get some kind of image in there. Nice. Now, if there's anything else that we have to change all the time when we come into templates, like if we wanted it to be in inches instead of mmgs, what if we wanted it to be in inches? We could go up to the gear icon. And anything in document properties, if we change any of this stuff, it's going to stick with this drawing template. So maybe I go and I change the units here to inches. Maybe we change it instead of being decimals, maybe we change it to fractions and 16th of an inch, something like that. And say, okay, that'll stick with this template also. Now, all we have to do to save it out as a template is choose Save As. And under the Save As, choose the Drawing Templates option, .drw. It'll take you right to wherever it's looking for training templates already. Well, in my case, training templates, but if you had it mapped to some area, it'll take you there. If you wanted to save it to a unique location, you could. And we can make SOLIDWORKS look at that location. So maybe I'll just save mine here, but I'll show you where we can change that also. So this will be new A portrait. Now we've got this thing saved as a drawing template. And if I go up to the gear icon at any point, I can see where SOLIDWORKS is looking for any kind of template at. Under System Options, File Locations, we can see it's looking for document templates currently in my training files, training templates folder. If I wanted to add any locations, like maybe this was a network location that everybody wanted to use, I could hit add and I could pick a different location with templates. And whenever we say okay in here, it'll show up as a new tab on our templates. As long as under our default templates, we have prompt user to select document template, we should see what I'm about to show you whenever we have a part. If I double click, I can get into my recent documents. Let's say we want to make a drawing of this thing. If I go to make a new drawing from it, now we can see this new A portrait template. And I could put a drawing view on there. Maybe put a smart dimension on the overall length of this thing. Looks like that couldn't be made into a 16th fraction. Let's see. Maybe we just call it 22 inches even. And maybe I also want to show it in that color view. I can click the view focus and change the display style of the part. And I could right click and edit sheet format and change any notes that I wanted to or anything like that. And then save this as a PDF, and you'll see how nice the little logo will look in the corner here. We'll save it as a PDF. This is what we could share with someone just that easily. And every time we make a new drawing from part now, we will be able to use the same template. So this really does wonders for getting everybody's drawings to look the same in your company. Let's see, something like that. Ah, it looks pretty nice. Thanks for watching today's video tech tip.